These players already have secured at least a top 3 spot here. They have already secured their trophy from the Europe International Championship, but they want to fight here for that first place, to become the champion, to take the throne from Tonton Batteuse. I'm guessing that Sanadu wants to keep the French legacy in there, but Emmy Weedle, the 2022 Senior World Champion, really wants to claim another title here.
And we're actually seeing two very interesting teams. Emmy Weedle is one of the few trainers who brought the Skeledirge to this tournament, and it has been shining for him. When we were looking at the teams of Emmy Weedle's games, it never looked like it was going to be super free, super strong, but he always made it happen and he convinced me.
Whether there were two water type Pokemon, a dragon type, a dark type, Emmy Weedle has always brought that Skeledirge, and it has been so good for him. As we take a look at his team here, the Skeledirge has such good coverage, having Incinerate for such great fire type damage. You have Shadow Ball to, well, do ghost damage, because it is a ghost type after all. And then you can also threaten dragon and dragon and dark types with the fairy type coverage, disarming voice. And then we also, Leo, have the Shadow Alolan Sandslash.
Shadow Alolan Sandslash has also been a staple in competitive play. And on the side of Sandodu, we see Shadow Poliwrath, one of my favorite fighting types. We see Guzzlord that has been so incredibly dominant this tournament. Shadow Gligar, of course. The name of the game is Shadow Gligar at this point. It's just everywhere. It's so safe. We also see Cresselia, Lickitung, and of course, the staple pick, Lantern.
Yeah, curious to see how these players are going to adapt to each other. I hope we get to see both Skeledirge and Guzzlord enter the field there. I believe both trainers are getting ready. Let's get into the first battle of the Europe International Championship. We have Vigoroth into Shadow Gligar.
And that is a rather neutral matchup, because Vigoroth is so good. It is one of the only counter users that doesn't lose heart to Gligar.
Yeah, it can actually win the zero shield scenario here. I'm guessing that is the scenario that Emmy Weedle might be looking for here. Skeledirge doesn't have a great matchup here, so you can't really swap it in here. Let's see what Emmy Weedle is going to do. Sanadu is letting the first bully slam go through. Let's see if he wants to go for switch advantage, going through for the ground type charge attack here. This will do a lot of damage, and Emmy Weedle is letting it through.
Oh, that is going to do a tremendous amount of damage, and this is going to put it into farm down range if you invest a shield on the Sandodu side. But I think that Emmy Weedle is going to be really fine with that, because the Gligar is also going to be put low. You can try to attempt a farm down with the Skeledirge. Oh!
Oh man, in comes the Crocodile, and in comes the ground type charge deck from Sandodu. If you don't shield this, this might knock out the Skeledirge. It's me, Emmy Weedle, going to shield. Oh, no! Oh, here we go! Boom! Boom! Almost knocks out the Skeledirge and gets the wing attack down. Skeledirge hasn't done anything, and Gligar has taken out the entire team from Emmy Weedle almost.
And Emmy Weedle is regretting this no shield. He's really annoyed by this. This was so much damage. Skeledirge is mostly used to win those games in the endgame, to get a lot of energy advantage and then play with it. But it wasn't a bait. This was the dig. And now we're going to see the Cresselia in the matchup against Lickitung, which is rather uncomfortable, especially if you run Moonblast.
Yeah, Lick is a super effective ghost type buzz attack, and the attack drop as well. Oh my goodness.
Is this a win con?
I think this may give Emmy Weedle some more play, but there's both the Lickitung and the Lantern to go through. And then on top of that, there's also a little bit on the Gligar remaining. This is such an uphill battle for Emmy Weedle, all because that notion. And in comes the Vigoroth again. The Lick fast attack doesn't do anything, so he can soak some damage here.
Oh, but can you actually use a shield here on the bottom stem to get more counter damage in? I really like this play by Emmy Weedle. The switch timer is not up for Sandodu, so he has to stay there in this matchup. But we're going to reach another body slam. Do you invest 2 shields in this very low Vigoroth? No!
No, he doesn't. Vigoroth goes down, protecting it by 1 shield, but not the second. And now it's all coming down to the Cresselia. I'm not sure if a Moonblast will knock out the Lickitung here. If so, that'd be great for Emmy Weedle, but you still have a full lance to go through here.
Can we get another debuff right here? And
not quite a boom, but however, we're going to attempt to knock out that Lantern really soon. It is a one shield scenario for both trainers. However, the Cresselia is so incredibly low.
Yeah, Cresselia, a very bulky Pokemon, has a positive matchup against his Lantern. You already see Sanadu having a relieved look here, but Lantern still has to finish his job here, going for the Thunderbolt here. And he still has a shield, but letting it go. I think if you shielded this, you may have actually gone to 2 Grasslop, but I'm not sure if you would have been able to knock the remaining Pokemon from Sanadu. Either way, Sanadu is taking game number 1 here in the winner's finals against Emmy Weedle.
Oh, what a strong matchup. Emmy Weedle went for a brave call. I mean, usually all the Shadow Gligars use Aerial Ace against Skeledirge, even though it is not super effective, because it costs less energy. You most likely get a shield out, and Emmy will try to be smarter than Sandodu in this situation.
This reminds me of Paul Asher versus Ani Frank yesterday, yeah. when we saw all the wild charge go through. Ani Frank was trying to make a smart call, and I think Emmy Weedle tried the same here. But when the opponent doesn't bait, it can almost knock out your Pokemon there, and that was just devastating for Emmy Weedle. I also must mention here, Leo, that these are the winner, the loser, and then we have the grand finals, which are best out of five. So Emmy Weedle has three battles still to come back against Sandodu here.
This is not match point for Sandodu just yet. He needs to win another one to get the match point, and then he has the chance to win it. Even maybe in a 3-0 sweep if he keeps on connecting digs on the Skeledirge like that. I think at this point I'm almost convinced you have to shield everything in this tournament.
Absolutely, Leo. Now, I'm curious how these players are going to adapt. Skeledirge wasn't exactly doing it for Emmy Weedle there. Sandodu maybe have prepared a little bit for this matchup, brought his strongest Pokemon against the Skeledirge in the Gligar, the Lickitung, and the Lantern. Skeledirge just had nowhere to go. Yeah. So yeah, here we see the replay again. That dig is coming through on Skeledirge. It's no shielded, and it did so much damage, and it basically made it useless.
And look at the reaction from Emmy Weedle. He is really, really not happy about this. Did not even read the disarming voice. And even though he got the debuff on the Moonblast, the Lickitung matchup was still not good enough.
Yeah, he was pumped for it. It is only a 10% chance to get that Moonblast attack drop, so that's not a very big chance. That may have given him a little bit more play, but it was not enough as the Lantern went for the final Thunderbolt here that knocked out the Cresselia and secured the lead here for Sandodu.
Oh, and I'm actually quite curious to see what these trainers are going to bring into the second match. They both had one entire day basically to prepare for this matchup. They know their teams. They had the entire night to look at each other's teams and come up with different strategies.
Yeah, I think at this point you might want to take a look at your other core breaker as Emmy Weedle. Alolan Sandslash is very weak to a Pokemon like Poliwrath, but it can do so well against Pokemon like Guzzlord and Gligar. I believe both trainers are ready. We are heading into game number two. We have the Lance from Sandodu into the Shadow Alolan Sandslash from Emmy Weedle.
And that is a very interesting matchup because the Shadow Alolan Sandslash is of course not as bulky as the Lantern. However, with the super effective Drill Run, you have very, very good play. The matchup is even positive, I would say, especially if you run Shadow Claw.
Yeah, you have Shadow Claw here as the fast attack from the community day that Sandshrew had a while ago. And this helps against Lantern. Most Alolan Sandslash have Power Snow, and that's resisted on Lantern, making the matchup considerably worse. But in this case, you actually can win the even shields unless you no-shield this Thunderbolt. I believe this Thunderbolt will not. Does Emmy Weedle call it again? Oh, he no-shoots again, Neo! Here we go! Oh, that takes it out! Oh, it actually doesn't take it out! It actually hangs on by 1 HP there! Getting to the Ice Punch and still winning the Ice Punch.
The zero shield scenario is won by him because the Shadow Claw added up so much that just the Ice Punch was enough here, and now the Wing Attack knocks out the Shadowlands Sandslash. Gligar confirmed a counter for Shadowlands Sandslash. I'm calling it right now. Shadow Gligar is farming up with a little bit of an energy advantage against the Cresselia. Cresselia needs a Moonblast and a Grass Knot to knock out the Shadow Gligar, but the Shadow Gligar is already queuing up that dig.
Yeah, I think at some point, if Sandodu decides to invest shields here, even two Grass Knot may knock out. But the thing that Sandodu probably is the most concerned about here is that Poliwrath in the back. It does have a lot of play against Cresselia. You're hoping that there's going to be a good matchup on the back, but you already saw the Alolan Sandslash lead, so you know that Poliwrath is going to be in a tough spot in the back. You need the Gligar to take out this Cresselia, perhaps even the backline as well.
Yep, and let's see if this goes no shielded. Emmy Weedle is just not shielding anything today. Is the Cresselia going to be able to detect it? Yeah, it takes it with basically 1 HP. Cues up the Grass Knot.
That's a lot of 1 HP here. And now, finally putting up a shield, Sandodu is looking at the camera. He feels a little bit confident there. Has the Poliwrath. Little does he know, there's another bad matchup for the Poliwrath here. It's the Gligar who has to carry here. Can you get to 2 charge stacks here? You're going to need it here. You need the Gligar, but going into the Poliwrath. Oh, going to try and perhaps debuff so he may be able to get to a charge stack later. Here comes a Thunderbolt. If you no-shield this will knock out the Poliwrath. Here we go. Can we get a zap here, Leo? If this comes through, here we go. Oh, it's no-shielded. Oh, zap! Takes out the Shadow Poliwrath!
Shadow Poliwrath is being knocked out here, and Shadow Gligar is at 2 dig. However, there's 2 shields remaining for Emmy Weedle, and Emmy Weedle takes this game with brave calls and the Lantern in the back against the Shadow Poliwrath that had no play.
Tying up the score to 1-1 here, as it should, in a winner's final. Yeah. What a tremendous game. I think just really tough alignment there for Sandodu. Seeing the Alolan Sandslash in the lead, having the Poliwrath in the back, you're gonna know that Emmy Weedle is protecting that Alolan Sandslash in the back. So it was just such a difficult matchup to play. play out for him. Maybe at some point you kind of had to bait out one of the counts for Poliwrath, but there were two of them.
Yep, that is true. That is the usual strategy. If you have the Shadowlands Sand Slash, you have two answers to counter users in the back. And Sandalu's play to get use of the Shadow Poliwrath was basically to swap it in on a low HP Shadowlands Sand Slash and get a counter down to get rid of some energy, but he didn't even get to the situation.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, let's see how these players are going to adapt to the next game. First, we see the replay here. We see the Alolan Sanchez taking the Thunderbolt here. And
Mido
actually decided to no-shield this, knowing the matchup. So actually, Sanadu missed a bubble there. And I think that's why the Alolan Sanchez managed to live this Ice Punch here. I thought I was going crazy. I thought I knew the matchup, but that's why. Then taking the dig there, barely getting to the grass out here, getting the crucial shield here from Sanadu. Sanadu felt confident, but the Poliwrath in the back had so little play here as it was going up against the Lantern with two shields. Mido knew he was just going for the Thunderbolt, and that would secure him the knockout and the battle here to tie up the score to 1-1.
Zip, zap, zooey. That Thunderbolt just took out that Shadow Poliwrath. It had no play whatsoever. Sometimes you bring the right Pokemon in the wrong position, and it doesn't really help you to win the game anymore. But we're going to advance to game three here, and this is going to be a very important one. You get to match point. You have the chance to qualify for the grand final if you win the next two games. So there is a lot of pressure on both of these trainers. It is a big stage. Both of them have been there before. Mido, he is used to big stages. He's a world champion.
He is the senior world champion 2022. He also has won the Stuttgart regional championship of 2023. I remember very well how he just basically outplayed me, and would not be surprised if he can get further here in the grand to the grand finals, but he first has to get through Sanadu. Sanadu has been putting up such a good show as well, usually not getting further than really the first round of day two, but now he's doing so well. We're getting into game number three here. We have the Lickitung from Sanadu into, again, the Alolan Sandslash from Mido.
And usually you would think Shadow Alolan Sandslash has the upper hand here. However, if you're running Shadow Claw, this is quite the positive matchup for the Lickitung.
This is the other side of the coin, right? You pick up land with Shadow Claw, but you drop the Lickitung matchup here. As you can see, the Shadow Claw, they do nothing here. However, you do resist all the charge attacks, so it's not the worst matchup here for the Shadow Alolan Sandslash.
Also, I like dropping the Lickitung matchup in this team composition. If you have the Vigoroth on your team, that Lickitung isn't a Pokemon that can be safe swapped anyways.
Yeah, exactly. And I think Sanadu is very happy to see the Alolan Sandslash here, considering his backline always bringing that Gligar. And if it's not on the Alolan Sandslash, you're usually in a pretty good spot. There's not a lot of bad matchups that Gligar has against Mido. Another Ice Punch goes through here, and Sanadu is still deciding to no shoot. Now, Leo, I'll tell you that Lickitung can win the zero shoot scenario here. This power whip might actually knock it out, and Mido is letting it through. If you can take one more Lake Fast Attack after this, you may get the attack. Let's see, can he do it? One HP. Oh, and he's catching on the Lantern. What a tremendous catch here from Sanadu. Très bien.
That is so good. The Lickitung still has a decent amount of health, can dish out some good Lick damage later. However, you're losing alignment, and now your Lantern is having the tough task of playing against the Cresselia that is running Grass Knot, a Grass-type charge attack.
Yeah, two Grass Knots will be enough here to take out the Lantern from Sanadu. Sanadu has some momentum here to think about this matchup, and he still has his Lickitung that he may need against the backline here from Mido. Both the Pokemon that he has don't do super well here, but we have a Charge Attack priority here. Going for the Surf, actually, not even the Thunderbolt. Mido still decided to not use a shield because Cresselia is so bulky and can take these Surfs like a champ.
And Sanadu is at way more than another Surf, so he puts up a Protect Shield and wants to maybe throw another Thunderbolt into the game. However, I think you're very okay. Oh, there is going to be a switch into the Lantern, the last full HP Pokemon that Mido has, and now this Thunderbolt is going to deal a big amount of damage if it goes unshielded. Do you shield this? This might be very crucial. He no shields this, thinking it's a Surf bait maybe. Immediate swap out here from Sanadu going into the Lickitung. Lickitung is racing up to a lot of energy. We are having an almost double Surf for Mido, and he's going to throw it.
Wow, such good counter from Mido, throwing right before the body slam. Lickitung, no energy, but going to put up the shield here. Sanadu needs to take out this Lantern here, but it has two shields. There also the Gligar in the back. It can take only one Surf, really. The second one would knock out. Mido finally putting up a shield here, and now preserving the Lantern to try and take the game for him.
Yeah, but let's see how good the counting of Mido is, because the Lickitung gets to yet another body slam. But Mido wants to try and farm down this Lickitung fully. There is no shields. Can you double surf the Gligar?
Yeah, I think at this point you have to. Sanadu does have the Lantern in the back still to have a potential catch. The timer's not going to be up yet. He's probably going to fully wait it out. You gotta have a catch here, though, to win this battle here, Leo.
Are we going to see another peekaboo play just for the win? We have seen this before by Lurgan Rocket. No, the timer isn't up yet. The Surf is going to connect easily onto the Shadow Gligar. This is going to deal above health. Do we see a catch after this, or is Emmy Weedle going to take this game with yet another Surf?
Oh,
we're waiting so much!
Waiting! And they're getting to the Surf! Does this no count? This is resisted damage. And this might barely be enough. Let's see. This is so crucial, Leo. It doesn't look out. Lantern hangs
Yo.
Up and comes out with another charge attack here.
Emmy Weedle is celebrating already. He's going to get to the Surf. The Surf is going to connect on the Shadow Gligar. Emmy Weedle reverses this and goes up in the lead 2-1.
Wow, what an incredible play from both players there. Both players waiting. And then Emmy Weedle was a little bit more patient and taking the game here to 2-1, taking the lead in the winner's finals. That was incredible.
Pokemon Go trainers when people stop tapping, right?
They lose their mind. We are losing our mind as well, Leo. That was so good to see both players predicting what they would do. Xanadu was waiting. Emmy Weedle was waiting, but he was patient enough. He has the momentum in the winner's finals. Maybe the experience helps him in this matchup to overcome his opponents.
Talking about both players, when both trainers are waiting, you have the momentum if you have the energy, so you can just wait out your opponent and wait if they try to go for the catch. You don't really have to throw the Surf.
Absolutely, especially because the Gligar wasn't even at a charge stack, so you weren't pressured at all to throw your charge stack. Here's such high level play from Emmy Weedle. Here we see the lead matchup. Shadowclaw alone and Sanchez doesn't have a great matchup against Lickitung. It does better against Lantern, but this is the other side of the coin, the matchup that you drop here. However, Lickitung against the Alola Sanchez with Shadowclaw actually can win the zero shield. But however, Xanadu decided to go for the catch here. However, that does mean he lost alignment. His Lantern then was aligned to the Cresselia, and then that puts Xanadu in such a tough spot. He had to go shields down again. He used the shield on the Lickitung, and as the Lantern from Emmy Weedle farmed down everything. Look at this, Leo. Both players waiting so long. Actually, we don't see it here, but we see the Surf there from the Lantern not being enough here.
Complete farm down from the Lantern, on the Lantern after this, going to throw the next Surf. And we're immediately going to go into game number 4 of the winner's finals. Emmy Weedle versus Xanadu, and we're going to see the same lead from game 1.
Yeah, we've seen this before. Previously, Xanadu had won this battle. Emmy Weedle decided back then to play the zero shoot scenario. Let's see if these trainers are going to do this again.
Oh, and Xanadu is going to be really happy to see the Vigoroth here in the lead because of the Lickitung that he is bringing. The Lickitung is looking super safe against Emmy Weedle's team unless there is the Vigoroth.
Yeah, alignment is... Oh man, let's take a look if Emmy Weedle this time decides to shield this. He is letting the dig go through. This does so much damage yet again. This is like game 1 again.
But you're going to get a shield from Xanadu, but Xanadu is going to be able to get a lot of energy on your Vigoroth. But Vigoroth still looks kind of healthy. Can you go for a complete farm down here? Oh, we're going to switch in the Cresselia immediately, and the Gligar is still at another dig. This is going to deal a huge amount of damage on the Cresselia.
Yeah, it is no shield again. Emmy Weedle's just using Cresselia as a damage boss. And I love this strategy from Emmy Weedle because he's baiting out the Lickitung with this Cresselia, so the Lantern in the back is free. This is such a high-level play. Go for the Moonblast, see if you can get the debuff again. It's a 10% chance, so the odds are not high. This time he does not get it.
But I also love what Xanadu is doing. This range from Gligar's HP is so, so important because it's really important to have this amount of HP against the Lantern. This is an uncomfortable range. You can never farm this Gligar down. It's still going to be of a lot of use.
Yeah, exactly. Cresselia is getting lower. Emmy Weedle, a shield keeper. He's not using his shields here. Cresselia is just taking all the damage today. And yeah, I think he's just going to put it all on the Lantern. Can he get to another Grazzle? Can he get to another Grazzle? Oh, just right before that, Xanadu goes for the body slam, making sure that the Lickitung is healthy enough to put in work against the Vigoroth, maybe keep it against the Lantern as well.
Perfect energy management. We're going to see the Vigoroth in here. And Vigoroth is actually dealing so much damage with the counter. You're actually forcing the energy off of the Lickitung. Very well played by Emmy Weedle, using this 5% HP Vigoroth, and the Lantern is there to sweep for the endgame. This is what the Lantern was born for. Lantern is going to be in the Mirage match now, but Emmy Weedle's Lantern has the energy advantage.
The energy advantage and the shield advantage. Yeah. This might come down to some baits. Xanadu still has the Gligar, which can put in a lot of work, as well. First Thunderbolt comes through from Emiweedle, and I think Xanadu is just keeping his shield for now, perhaps for that Gligar, because the spark from Lantern is not very effective on Gligar, so Gligar would have some momentum as well going for the bait here. Emiweedle has been keeping his shields all day. This will be a crucial notion if he does it again. And he does it again! He goes another bait! Emiweedle's cheering! This is huge for him, because you need those shields against the Gligar!
That is a proper win condition for Emiweedle here. Now he can shield the second surf as well. This would put the Lantern into way too low, but the Gligar is still going to be important. Emiweedle has so much energy, throws a surf here, but this is going to be really, really close. Does this knock out? This is going to be so important. The surf is going to connect in just a second.
Oh, we saw earlier not knocking out. This time it does knock out. It's barely enough to take out the Lantern, and now you have Gligar, but Lantern from Emiweedle has so much energy. And we see the Link Stone coming. Can it get to a charge? It does get to a body slam. This might be huge. Can you even shield this as Emiweedle? He does. He has so much energy, though. It now comes down to the energy on the Gligar. I don't think Xanadu has a lot of energy here because he threw the thing into Cresselia. It has nothing, and Emiweedle has two Surf here.
Two Surf are going to be enough to knock out the Shadow Gligar. Xanadu is shaking his head. Was this it? Do I have to go into the loser's bracket now? Was this my winner's run? The Surf is going to connect. Shadow Gligar is going to be fainting. The Lickitung is at basically one HP. One Spark is enough to advance to the Grand Finals. Emiweedle takes down Xanadu!
Emiweedle advances to the Grand Finals of Championship Sunday in here at the Europe International Championship in London. What a tremendous play from both of these players. Emiweedle played so well, such great strategies, and not to forget his opponent played so strong as well. Yeah.